Following our previous lesson, today we'll delve into the direct comparison test. Similar to the integral test covered in the last class, the direct comparison test also requires certain conditions to be met. To make it easy to remember, let's add another P here and put two red PP. Each P signifies positivity, indicating that both A sub n and V sub n we'll be using must be positive. Let's first understand what the direct comparison test is. Suppose we have two positive sequences, A sub n and B sub n, where B sub n is greater than or equal to A sub n for all n. Then, if the sum of B sub n as n goes from 1 to infinity converges, then the sum of A sub n as n goes from 1 to infinity also converges. The contrapositive statement of this is, if the sum of A sub n as n goes from 1 to infinity diverges, then the sum of B sub n as n goes from 1 to infinity also diverges. To better understand why this is the case, let me illustrate it with a simple diagram. When B sub n is greater than or equal to A sub n, and both are positive for all n, we have the first statement of the direct comparison test. Let me explain why if the infinite sum of B sub n converges, then the infinite sum of A sub n also converges. Do you see the slope here? Since the infinite sum of B sub n is positioned higher than A sub n, if it converges to some arbitrarily positive value L, what happens? The infinite sum of A sub n below must be less than or equals to L and cannot exceed it no matter what. Therefore, the sum of A sub n also converges. Here we have the second statement of the direct comparison test. If the infinite sum of A sub n diverges, then the infinite sum of B sub n also diverges. Looking at the slope, you can see that the infinite sum of B sub n is positioned higher than the infinite sum of A sub n because B sub n is greater than A sub n. Now, if the infinite sum of A sub n diverges to infinity, what happens? This infinite value keeps increasing, climbing higher and higher on the slope endlessly. Consequently, if the infinite sum of A sub n keeps climbing endlessly, the infinite sum of B sub n, which already has a greater value, also must climb endlessly, leading to its divergence. Did you understand? When using the direct comparison test, there are two things to be cautious of. The first is, when the infinite sum of A sub n converges to an arbitrary value L, what happens to the infinite sum of B sub n in this case? The infinite sum of B sub n could converge slightly higher than L, or it could keep climbing up the slope and diverge. Therefore, we cannot definitely determine anything about the infinite sum of B sub n. The second caution is when the infinite sum of B sub n, which is greater than the infinite sum of A sub n, diverges to infinity. What happens to the infinite sum of A sub n in this case? The infinite sum of A sub n could converge to an arbitrary value or diverge to infinity by climbing up the slope continuously. Therefore, once again, we cannot determine whether the infinite sum of A sub n converges or diverges. In summary, to use the direct comparison test, we only need to consider whether a larger value converges or a smaller value diverges. Please remember this well. Now, let's work on a few examples together. The first problem is the infinite sum of 1 over n cubed plus 8. Let's consider a similar series, the infinite sum of 1 over n to the power of 3. To apply the direct comparison test easily, we need to find a series that is similar to the given one and compare them. Since the value of p is 3, which is greater than 1, according to the p series test, this series converges. If you want to learn more about p series test, please click on the link top right corner. Knowing that the comparison series converges, we need to find a larger series than the one given in the problem. Here, we can use 1 over n to the power of 3 for comparison. Then, the infinite sum of 1 over n to the power of 3 plus 8 becomes less than or equal to the infinite sum of 1 over n to the power of 3. Now, according to the p series test, the series on the right converges because the value of p is greater than 1, which means it converges. By the direct comparison test, if a larger series converges, then the given series should also converge. Therefore, the infinite sum of 1 over n to the power of 3 plus 8 converges. The second example is the infinite sum of 1 over 2 plus square root n. This problem resembles the infinite sum of 1 over n to the power of half. Since the value of p for this series is half, it diverges. Therefore, To use the direct comparison test, we need to find a smaller sequence than the one given in the problem. Taking the reciprocal of the series in the problem is 2 plus square root n, which can be less than or equals to n. However, n should be greater than or equals to 4. Because the convergence of a series is not dependent on its first few terms, you can modify the test to require only for n greater than some integer value. Now, if you take the reciprocal of these expressions again, 1 over n becomes smaller than or equal to 1 over 2 plus square root n. Therefore, the term that fits into the yellow box here is 1 over n. And the infinite sum of 1 over n becomes smaller than or equals to the infinite sum of 1 over 2 plus square root n. However, the infinite sum on the left diverges because by the p-series test, with p equals to 1, it diverges. Hence, it follows that the infinite sum on the right, which is greater, also diverges. Let's consider the infinite sum of ln n over n. This problem can be also be analyzed using the integral test to determine convergence or divergence. You can refer to the related video in the top right corner for more information. Ln n over n can be greater than or equal to 1 over n, which requires n to be greater than or equal to 3. Therefore, the infinite sum of 1 over n becomes smaller than or equal to the infinite sum of ln n over n. Applying the p-series test to the left-hand side, since the value of p is 1, it diverges. Consequently, the right-hand side also diverges. Now, let's consider the infinite sum of n squared plus 2 over n to the power 4 plus 5. This problem shares similarities with the infinite sum of 1 over n squared overall. And since the value of p is 2, the infinite sum of 1 over n squared converges. Since the comparison sequence 1 over n squared converges, we need a comparison sequence that is larger than the given problem. Let's start by removing the 5 in the denominator of the left expression. Then it becomes n squared plus 2 over n to the power 4. And since the denominator of this sequence is smaller than that of the left sequence, we can conclude that this sequence is overall larger than or equals to the left sequence. And if we express this expression as two fractions, it becomes 1 over n squared plus 2 over n to the power 4. Now, comparing the infinite sums, the infinite sum of n squared plus 2 over n to the power 4 plus 5 is less than or equals to the sum of the infinite sum of 1 over n squared and the infinite sum of 2 over n to the power 4. The infinite sums on the right by the p-series test converge since their respective p-values are 2 and 4, both greater than 1. Since a larger infinite series than the one on the left converges, the left infinite sum must also converge eventually. To apply the direct comparison test, you first need to identify a comparable sequence. If the sum of this sequence converges, you should find a larger sequence for comparison. Conversely, if the compared sequence diverges, you should find a smaller one for comparison. This process helps determine whether the given series converges or diverges. If today's video has been helpful to you, please like and subscribe. I look forward to seeing you again in the next video. Thank you for watching. Until next time, I've been your math guardian, Alex.